Listen, I need to talk to you about meeting my parents tomorrow. I'm worried that my dad might say something rude to you. He can be pretty harsh and offensive when he doesn't like someone. You don't have to take him seriously, so can you please just ignore him if he does say anything stupid?
What? Are you serious? I'm just going to introduce myself as your fiancé. Why would he say something rude to me? That makes no sense. Is there any reason why he would hate me? Shouldn't you talk to your dad about that instead of warning me? I don't understand why I have to put up with his insults if he does say something mean.
Well, yeah, I tried to talk to him, but he's really stubborn, like super stubborn. So once he gets an idea in his head, he won't let it go. I just want to avoid making things worse.
Once he gets an idea in his head, what idea does he have about me, even though we've never met before? Did I do something wrong?
It's not you, it's just about your family.
What about my family? He hasn't met them either.
Okay, I never told him that your family isn't farming. When I first told him about you, I lied about your family. I said they were all office workers and stuff. I hid the fact that you're not from the city. Then we moved in together and we got engaged, and over time, it just got harder to tell him the truth.
Why would you lie about something like that? Were you embarrassed of me not being a city girl? I really don't get what you were thinking.
I wasn't embarrassed. I just couldn't tell him because I know that my dad hates farmers and stuff. I knew that we couldn't get married without him knowing the truth, so I told him earlier and he freaked out. He was really angry about your background.
Seriously? You're not joking with me, are you? I'm already nervous enough about meeting your parents, and this is not helping. If you're not joking, then I don't get what's wrong with being a farmer. I'm proud of my family's history in the area and the organic produce we grow. If he has a problem with farmers, then he clearly doesn't appreciate that food is essential for life, and that he should be thankful for farmers for their hard work every day. I don't get why he would be mad at you either.
Yeah, well, he's probably going to be a jerk tomorrow, so just brace yourself. There's nothing else I can do to change his mind about you. You'll just have to do your best to keep calm and not make him angrier. I want you guys to get along.
You've got to be kidding me. You're not going to stand up for me? I'll do my best to be polite, of course, but I'm going to need you to back me up. We're going to get married, remember? There will be times when you'll have to choose a side or intervene if your dad is really that difficult to deal with. Philip, are you listening?
You filthy farmer girl. How could you ever think you were good enough for my son? You must have been scheming to marry him and leech off his wealth. But you can forget about that. He's going to inherit my restaurant someday, and I won't let a country bumpkin ruin it. You don't deserve him or the fortune he'll be getting. You're just a gold digger.
What? Is that what you think of me? You're unbelievable. I was hoping to get an apology from you after what you did, but instead I get this nonsense. You're an adult. You should act like one. You should take responsibility and apologize for your actions. I never expected Philip's parents to be so unreasonable and rude.
I don't owe you anything, you lowly peasant. You have no business being in my house. Do you hear me? We don't want your kind here. You don't belong with my son. I was fooled by your lies about your family, but now I know the truth. You're nothing but a farmer from a hick town.
Did I really lie to you? I just came here because you invited me over. I wanted to introduce myself properly before I married Philip. That's all. And then when you went crazy and poured hot soup all over me? What's wrong with you? I have burns on my face and arms, and you don't even care. Are you serious? What did I ever do to you?
You deserved it, you poor and pathetic girl. You should look the part if you're going to be a farmer. Maybe then no one else will make the mistake of falling for you. You were lucky to even taste my soup when it dripped down your face. It's too good for a woman like you.
I don't care what kind of soup it was. It doesn't matter if it was cream of brie or cream of crap. You had no right to do that to me. If you're not going to apologize, then maybe I'll have to find another way to make you pay for what you did.
Pay for what I did? Don't make me laugh. Why should I pay for anything? You got what was coming to you. You should know your place in society. You have no right to complain about what I did to you.
You have a lot of nerve kicking me out of your house. I thought that since you owned such a prestigious restaurant, you would have some manners and decency. But I guess I was wrong. Are you sure you're the owner?
How many times do I have to tell you? I own a restaurant that people like you can only dream of entering. Don't you understand English? Or are you too dumb to comprehend what I'm saying, you hillbilly?
Oh, really? That's too bad. Because if you were the owner, you would have recognized my last name. But you didn't even blink when I told you who I was. Are you pretending not to know? Hoping that it's just a coincidence? Or are you really that clueless and ignorant? You've gone too far with this joke, if that's what it is.
What are you talking about? Why would I recognize your last name? I don't remember ever meeting anyone from your background. And even if I did, I wouldn't bother remembering them. As far as I know, this is the first time I've encountered anyone with that name.
Oh, is that so? Well, that's a shame. Because if you did recognize my name, maybe things would have been different.
Oh, are you finally going to give up on marrying my son? Have you realized that you're not worthy of him?
No, that's not it at all. I'm giving up on marrying Philip because I don't want to deal with a father-in-law who thinks he can abuse me whenever he feels like it. I want nothing to do with you or your family ever again. As far as I'm concerned, this engagement is over.
Good riddance. I don't want a daughter-in-law who's going to embarrass my family and ruin my reputation. I knew from the start that you were after my son's money and status. But now he's free from your clutches. He's lucky that I intervened and saved him from making a huge mistake. You can go back to your farm and find someone more suitable for your level of class, or lack thereof. I'm sure there are plenty of rednecks out there who would love to marry a scrawny country mouse like you. My son is too good for a simpleton like you. Find someone who's in your league or lower. I know it'll be hard, but why should I care? As long as you stay away from me and my restaurant.
Wow, you really are a condescending asshole. I'm surprised your business actually made it this far with you looking down on farmers the way you do. Your restaurant doesn't deserve the label of being prestigious at all. If you can't respect the work that farmers do, then you obviously have no respect for food. You even prove that by wasting a perfectly good bowl of soup.
You don't have the right to lecture me about respecting food. I know better than anyone what food means in this world. It means that I make a profit, and that's all that matters. I won't let one farmer girl ruin my business. I'm lucky I managed to get rid of you before the wedding, so I'll let you off this time. But don't even think about trying to stay in touch with my son. He obviously doesn't realize how close we were to making asses of ourselves. But he'll be over you in no time, and he'll find someone more worthy of being part of our family. I won't ever let anyone like you near him ever again. I got to hope that this serves as a lesson to him too. To not bring anyone like you into our home. But I'm shocked that you even had the audacity to think that you could marry my son in the first place. You should be more aware of your place.
Just thinking about how we were one step away from letting our son marry some random farmer girl makes me shudder. You had no right to invade our home like that. Pouring the cream of brie on you was the only way to get you to wake up and realize you don't belong here. You should leave and never come back.
Then I'd be happy to cancel the engagement.
That's my line.
Great. I'm glad we've come to an understanding about that at least. But don't come begging for me to get back with your son once your business starts falling apart. And you sure you don't want to apologize now while you still can? I'll give you one last chance.
What are you talking about? What can you possibly do? I've prevented my business from falling apart by avoiding the worst case scenario of you marrying my son and driving us into bankruptcy. I've protected my family from scum like you and your family. I don't have anything to apologize for.
Then I'll have to notify my parents about the engagement being canceled. My parents already knew that I was due to visit you today, so they were horrified when they saw me with burns on my face at the hospital. My dad's already spoken with the family lawyer and is preparing to take action.
What? You have a lawyer already?
I don't want to have anything to do with you. And my parents feel the same way. They're not interested in dealing with such a dangerous man.
I'm surprised you even have access to a lawyer. I guess you must be the fancier sort of farmer. But there's no point threatening me with a lawsuit. You'll never be able to beat the team of lawyers I have on standby. You don't even have the financial means to match me. You're just going to waste your time and your money by trying to bring me to court. So I suggest you give up before you're utterly defeated.
That may be so. I don't know how much better your lawyer is, but maybe you should take another look at my last name before you do anything else. You should know better than anyone else that my parents are the ones that have been providing your restaurant with fresh vegetables for a very long time. And yet, you didn't even realize.
What?
We've had a contract with your business, but as a result of your idiocy, my parents have decided to end that contract, effective immediately. I don't know how you plan to procure vegetables for your business from tomorrow onwards, but this is what you wanted, right? You said that you didn't want to have anything to do with our sort of people, right? I'm just a random farmer girl from a hick town, right?
What are you talking about? Your parents were supplying my restaurant with vegetables?
You're not being serious, are you? You don't even know that and you're the owner. You should be aware of every detail, especially where you're getting your ingredients from. Just how irresponsible are you? The owner is supposed to have the biggest say in what kind of ingredients you use and where you get them from, and you don't know? Are you sure you're the owner? I can't believe a restaurant owner like you actually exists. You can't even express any gratitude towards the people that grow the vegetables you use in every single meal. How do you think you've made such a profit until now? If it weren't for the farmers that provide you with fresh organic produce, you wouldn't even have a business.
Are you being serious? Does your family really own the farm that we have a contract with?
I really don't believe that you're the one that's running that restaurant. You've got someone else running the business from the shadows, don't you? I can't imagine that your restaurant would be so successful with someone like you at the top. Besides, a real owner would know who he has contracts with and would show them the courtesy and respect they deserve. This all happened because you're an ignorant ass that doesn't know the first thing about owning a restaurant, or food for that matter.
How do you know that? Did Philip tell you that? It's supposed to be a family secret.
I knew it. Philip hasn't said anything to me about how you run your business. I can tell just by the way you act and from the way you wasted that soup. If you really did have full control of the restaurant, you would be aware of the contracts your business has, and you would have recognized my name. You would have a lot more respect for farmers and for everyone involved in the process of delivering a meal to your customers. You're just the owner in name and have someone else running your business, don't you? I have nothing against that itself. But the fact that you make yourself out to be a superior existence because of your owner status annoys me to no end. You know nothing about food and have no respect for the people that grow the vegetables and raise the cows and chickens you eat. I bet you don't even know the difference between a farm and a ranch, since you told me to return to a ranch. I bet you don't even know that vegetables come from farms and not from the supermarket. That's why you were looking down on us.
Shut up. Why should I care what a stupid farmer thinks? It's true that my restaurant uses a lot of vegetables. So now I think about it, farmers have some good use after all. But even so, that doesn't make them any better than me. Farmers are just pawns. They're just tools that rich people like me make use of. You'd all be useless without me.
Oh, really? If that's the case, then I'm sure you won't be troubled if we decide to end our contract with your business. You can find some other pawn that's willing to deal with your crap. Your general manager, the real executive behind the business, is panicking quite a bit. Haven't you heard anything from him?
What? I have some messages from him. But is it really that big of a deal? Our restaurant is renowned nationwide. Why do we have to worry about one farm refusing to provide us with vegetables? We can find another place to make a contract with, no problem. So what if your family doesn't want to do business with us? There are hundreds of other farms that will be delighted to have the chance to work with such a reputable restaurant.
You really are stupid.
What did you say?
My family runs a famous farm that has a history that goes back to my great-grandfather's generation. We only deal in organic vegetables of the highest quality. Didn't you know that it was because of our vegetables that your restaurant became so famous? Without us, you're nothing.
Really?
You really didn't know. How ignorant are you when it comes to your own business? You have no right to call yourself the owner of that restaurant if you don't know a single thing about it. You've just been wallowing in your pride and self-righteousness, believing that your restaurant's popularity made you a successful and competent businessman. But you don't even know that there was a TV program that picked up the ingredients used in your meals and highlighted the use of organic vegetables. That's how your restaurant gained so much recognition. You don't even have an idea of what might happen to your restaurant if you lose this contract. Oh, I can say that? It's a shame.
What are you talking about? I've had enough of you talking to me like that. Wait, my general manager really is panicking. What's going on? He says that if we end this contract, we'll end up having to close the business. What does this mean?
I've already warned you several times today. Are you even listening to me properly? But it's too late to start regretting your actions now. I asked you for an apology, and you refused.
Hannah, was it?
What? Now you're asking me for my name?
You can marry my son. I'll allow it.
Excuse me?
There have been a lot of misunderstandings. But now I understand that you're not just a farmer, girl. I'd be delighted to accept your marriage to my son. Can we forgive and forget everything that's happened up until now?
Are you freaking kidding me? Of course I'm not going to accept that.
What? Why?
What you've done, the way you've acted, is absolutely unacceptable. And it's not just you that's the problem. I don't want to marry your son. I've completely fallen out of love with Philip. It was enough that you went as far as pouring hot soup on me, but I've lost it with him. I can't respect you, and I can't see Philip as a reliable and caring partner anymore. Even though you did something so dangerous, he didn't even try to stop you. He just watched it happen. He didn't even make a move to help me when I was wiping myself off. He could have at least driven me to the hospital, but no. Once Daddy got angry, he just left me out to dry. There's no point in marrying a man like that if I know I can't trust him to be on my side. I'm canceling the engagement.
You're overreacting. I didn't do anything that bad. All I did was help you eat the cream of brie.
It was still hot, and I've got scalds and burns. Any adult with a little common sense would know that it's dangerous to do something like that, and yet you did it. You didn't even apologize, so you can't argue that you didn't mean to. And one more thing, my family is fortunate enough to have gained a lot of respect from other farmers, so we have a lot of influence.
What?
My parents are furious about what happened, and they've already spoken with everyone they know about your behavior and what you really think about farmers with this. Nobody will want to make a contract with your restaurant, and you'll be stuck making tasteless meals without any vegetables, and you'll eventually have to accept bankruptcy.
You're lying!
None of the local organic farmers will want to work with you, and you'll find it difficult to get in touch with any farmers out of state, too. Even if you did find someone, they'd be too far away for you to be able to consider the delivered vegetables fresh. The only reason your restaurant was so popular and was able to make a profit was because it was making a name for itself by using only the freshest and organic produce. That's all ruined because you didn't want to treat your son's fiancé with a little respect. You've got no choice but to accept that your life as a superior business owner is over.
No, you're just bluffing. There's no way we can't find someone that will deliver vegetables to us. This can't be happening. My business was going so, so well until now. How can everything be ruined by us losing one contract? Please, you can't do this. My restaurant won't be able to function if we don't have any vegetables.
It's your own fault for looking down on farmers the way you did. If you're so high and mighty, why don't you do something about it yourself instead of relying on a lowly farmer?
Girl, you must be able to do everything yourself since you're so much better than me. I'm honestly, sincerely sorry. I should never have spoken to you like that. I should never have treated you like that. Please, help me. Otherwise, I'll have to shut down my business. I'll lose everything.
I already told you that you shouldn't come crying to me after your business starts falling apart. It is far too late. You should reflect on what you've done. But it's a shame that you'll only regret what you've done because of the effect it's going to have on your life, and not because of the effect it's going to have on mine.
Please, I'll get down on my hands and knees. I'll do anything, so please let me protect my business. I don't want to lose my restaurant. I'll let you marry Philip. So please forgive me.
No matter how much you beg, there's no point. I already tried to get along with you before you poured soup on me. But you wouldn't listen to anything I had to say. Begging me for forgiveness doesn't change the fact that I've got burns and that you've insulted my family. I've already reported this incident to the police, too.
What?
Our lawyers are ready to take your lawyers on in court, so you better prepare yourself. I'm not going to back down until I've gotten the justice I deserve for everything you've said and done. I'm sorry for being a farmer's girl from the sticks, but you'll regret underestimating farmers and wish you had never disrespected us. You told me to leave and never come back, but you're the one that doesn't belong in the restaurant business. See you in court, asshole. I'm going to send you to hell myself. Dylan's violent behavior backfired on him and landed him in trouble with the law. The police took him away for questioning, leaving his restaurant in chaos. He couldn't do anything to save his restaurant from closing down, as his customers and staff left in disgust. He lost all hope of reopening another restaurant, as the public criticized him harshly for his actions. He became a laughingstock and a pariah in the culinary world. Philip was desperate to get back together with me, and Dylan tried to persuade me to give them another chance, but I rejected all of their pleas and cut off all ties with Philip and his family. I had no intention of marrying into such a horrible family. My parents used their influence to spread the word about Dylan and made sure he could never find anyone to make a contract with him ever again. He went bankrupt, and the story of how a once-loved restaurant had plunged into disfavor was all over the news. Dylan became infamous online, and the criticisms never ceased. He had no choice but to move away and start anew. Nobody knows where he's gone or what he's doing. Maybe he's still trying to run a restaurant somewhere, or maybe he's given up on his passion altogether. Either way, I don't care. I'm just glad I got out of that nightmare before it was too late.